In this video, we're going to look at how we can manage our iCloud storage space through our iPad. We're going to see how we can see how much space we are using in iCloud, which apps are using the most space in iCloud, and then also what we can do to manage that space. Maybe we need to delete some data, or what we may need to do is just purchase more storage. If we've removed enough data, we can also lower how much storage we are paying for. Let's take a look at how we manage our iCloud storage through our iPad. Let's go to my iPad. So I'm in my iPad here. How can I find out how much storage I am using? How can I see which apps are using that storage or which data with which apps are using that storage? Well, in order to do that, what we need to do is we need to go to our settings app. Now I am using iPadOS 16, but it pretty much works the same way even if you're using an older version of iPadOS. From here, what I need to do is I need to go to my name up here at the top. When I tap on my name, I go over to iCloud. Up at the top, you're going to see how much space you have. So I have 2 terabytes. I'm using 1 terabyte. So what is using that space? Well, if we go over to the left, you're going to see that my photos, docs, and others, these are the colored bars here, are not using a lot of space. But this turquoise bar here is using a lot of space. What is that turquoise bar? Well, if we go over here, you're going to see it's family. Now, this is a family account that I am on. So another account that I'm sharing this account with is using all of the storage. So what I'd have to do is log into or go to that iPad, and then I could manage that storage. But let's just say that this iPad here was using a lot of storage. How can I see which apps are using that storage? And then what can I do about it? Well, what we need to do is we need to go to Manage Account Storage. When I tap on this, you're going to see a list of all of the apps that are using storage in iCloud. Now, this is not for the iPad. This is for iCloud. So we can see that my photos here is using the most storage. This is why it's at the top. So it's sorting it by the apps that are using the most storage. And if we go over to the right, I can see it's using 3.3 gigabytes. I can see that my backups here are using 1.2 gigabytes. And then my mail here is using 142 megabytes. So now, what can I do to remove some of the storage? Let's say I wanted to clear up some space. Well, the first place I would look would be your backups. Backup stores all of your different backups from all of your different Apple devices. Well, let's say you had an older iPhone you no longer use. Maybe you gave it away or you recycled it. Well, in some cases, you still may have a backup for that you no longer need. So what you want to do is you just need to delete that old backup. How do you do that? Well, all you have to do is just tap on this, and then you're going to see all of your backups. So let's just say this iPhone 12 is an older phone that I no longer have. I recycled it or I gave it to someone. Maybe I traded it in. I don't need this backup anymore. From here, what I do is I tap on this, and then you're going to see delete backup. It will only delete the backup of that older iPhone. So that's the first place I would look is backups, especially if you've been using Apple products for a while. You may be surprised at how many backups you actually have there. Another thing you can do is just remove files from iCloud. How do you know which files to remove? Well, let's go over to Keynote here. We can see that I'm using 368 megabytes. I'd like to get rid of some of those older Keynote presentations. Well, here are a list of all of the different presentations that I have in iCloud. So now what I'm able to do is go over to my Files app on my iPad, and then I go over to iCloud and Keynote, and I'd be able to find these different presentations. And then from there, what I'm able to do is delete it through the Files app. So you can see which documents are using all of your storage within a specific app. Now, you do have to go to the Files app to delete any of those files. You can't do it directly from the settings here. But at least you can get an idea of which apps are using your storage or which apps are storing a lot of data. Now, another thing you could do is just delete all of the documents and data. What this is going to do is delete all of the Keynote documents in iCloud. So if you no longer use Keynote, you could just click on this to delete all of the data. If we go over to Photos here, what I'm able to do is turn off iCloud photos and then delete them from iCloud. So it's going to remove all of the photos from iCloud. It's not going to remove them from your Photos app on the iPad, but it will remove them from iCloud. So basically what you'll need to do is just take a look at these individually, and you really only have to look at the ones that are towards the top here. I'm not going to worry too much about these smaller apps here, like Safari that is using 2.3 megabytes. That's not a lot of space. But in your case, what you may see at the top here is an app that is using a lot of space, and then what you may want to do is just go and manage that space. Now, let's say that you couldn't remove any more space, and you're still low on storage. What can you do? Or maybe you removed a lot of space and you want to reduce your plan. I'm on a 2 terabyte plan. Maybe I only need to have a 200 gigabyte plan. How can I manage what plan I'm on once I've reduced the space? Or maybe I need to get more space. In order to do that, what we need to do is go over to Change Storage Plan. When I tap on this, what I'm able to do is change my storage plan. Now, I can't do it with this particular iPad because I'm on a family plan. But if you are on your plan and you are the manager of that plan, what you're able to do from here is just select which plan you want. You can upgrade and you can downgrade. So if you've cleared off a lot of space, you may be able to save some money as well. Or maybe what you need to do is just spend a little bit more money for more storage. So that is how we can manage our storage, our iCloud storage, through the iPad. Basically, what we need to do is just go over to our Settings app. And then once we go to the Settings app, we tap on our name at the very top. And then from there, we go to iCloud, and you'll be able to see which apps are using your storage. You can go through the different apps individually. And if you saved a lot of space, you're able to change your storage plan. Or if you need more space, you may also upgrade your plan. So that is how we manage our iCloud storage through the iPad.